You're probably used to seeing and writing the code here to create an object, an array, and function. These are in the literal format. These lines down here produce the same end result but are in the constructor format. The constructor format for each of these is not recommended for several reasons. It's not readable, it can be harder to work with, and it's slower. But the constructor function does offer one benefit over a function literal. It can dynamically create a function at runtime. Remember that underscore's template function's job is to construct a function. It does so by using the constructor function format. Here is a function that takes two numbers and adds them together. It's written in the literal format. This function does the same thing, but it is written using a constructor function. The last argument to a constructor function is the body of the function. Any arguments before the last one will become parameters for the function. This makes constructor functions really handy because they can create functions with a dynamically supplied body. So adder1 results in 3, and adder2 gives us 7. This make function accepts one argument and returns a newly created function. I'll call make and pass to it the string fun. This returns a new function. This isFun function is waiting to be called with some data. If I pass biking, I'll get the string biking is fun returned to me. Passing in climbing or broccoli makes them fun too.